Flat earthers never do science. Flat earthers never prove anything.
Okay, let's see how float glass is made. For your info, float glass is also commonly referred to as flat glass. Literally called flat glass. We're gonna see why. First of all, what is the definition of molten? Especially of materials with a high melting point, such as metal and glass, liquefied by heat. Liquefied literally means it is a liquid. So, float glass is made by pouring the molten or liquid glass from a furnace into a chamber that contains a bed of liquid tin. So you are pouring one liquid onto another liquid. Let's see what happens. The upper surface of the glass is called the air side or score side. It is polished with fire. The lower surface is called the tin side. It is not fire polished. From the chamber, the glass enters an oven called a lair. There it slowly cooled at a specific rate. This process is called annealing. Relieves the glass of internal stresses. The rate of cooling is crucial to the success of the final project. The glass emerges from the lair at room temperature as a continuous ribbon. It is flat, fire finished on top, and has smooth parallel surfaces. That proves it is locally flat and level. The bottom surface of the glass laying directly on top of the tin is parallel to the top surface that settles flat and level. Automatic cutters trim the edges and cut the glass to length. This manufacturing process that happens every day all over Earth proves liquids lay flat and level at the surface. If you are going to claim somehow gravity allows liquid to start displaying curvature upon its surface, you need to provide mechanically measured, scientific method-based evidence of such, which to this day there has never, ever been produced such evidence. So we have proven liquids lay locally flat and level, which is our baseline to determine the Earth that is 70% liquid, according to science, must be flat and level until otherwise proven by your theory of gravity. And the mechanical measurement evidence backing it, which you seem to lack throughout history. The technology is readily available. We would love it if you would get to proving your ridiculous theory that gravity magically makes water curve when it doesn't ever do so under any circumstances when at rest on the rest of the Earth. Curving water on its surface is an absurdity, and this proves it.